Evening all. Well, I got completely fed up of waiting for the Amanco head gasket holder to arrive, so I took it upon myself to make my own. Probably not the best thing you've ever seen, but it should get me out of trouble, and if it's no good then I'll have a backup. But I just wanted to show you what I did last night. Made an all steel handle for this engine. It's much stronger. The other handle, I was just worried about it snapping. So those wooden brackets there eventually will be replaced by steel. But, you know, this will do the job for now. Solid steel, that bit's stainless. This is just mild steel. Fixed with split pins there. So I was quite pleased with that. But anyway, there's my gasket. Made of Tesnit gasket material. That's a modern non-asbestos fibre. You know, quite a good material and reasonably thick, so I'm going to try and get the cylinder head on today. So, fingers crossed, it'll be the last time you see that side of it. So take a good look. Just to remind you, that patch there that looks like filler, it isn't, it's some sort of chemical metal. That was a frost repair there, but it seems so solid I'm going to leave it well alone. So. Anyway, we'll try and get the head on now for you. Well, there we go, that's the cylinder head on, and she's got fantastic compression. Now, first of all, I must explain, those of you who perhaps haven't come across the Amanco before or are not familiar with these engines, they've got an atmospheric inlet valve. Now, that means it's operated by the vacuum in the cylinder. As the piston travels backwards like that, it sucks the valve open. And the exhaust valve is mechanically operated by a rocker, which we have here. You can see that would go there, and there's a striker arm running up to the cam there, operating that. It's a very basic engine. Now, Chris said to me, are you going to set it up as a hit and miss? Now, Chris, there's two types of Amanco, the hit and miss and the throttle governed. The hit and miss was straight petrol, whereas this is a petrol paraffin. You started it on petrol and then switched over to paraffin once warm. Now, the hit and miss Amanco, the way that works, you've got a sort of latching mechanism along here, along where the picker rod is, and that holds the exhaust valve open. Now, with that open, obviously it's like a on your diesel engine, it's decompressed, it's just spinning over. When it closes, the atmospheric inlet valve is sucked in, fuel drawn in, the igniter trips, and the engine fires. And it will fire once, or however many times it needs to get back up to its rated speed again. It'll then freewheel down, and of course the governor weights operate the catch on this. So imagine the catch is in, the arms work by that, engine slows down. Collar moves across, catch out, exhaust valve closed, and inlet valve opens, exhaust valve works again as the engine fires, then it goes back over, latching again, freewheeling. This is a throttle governed engine, just like, you know, any other four stroke throttle governed engine, though a little more basic. So I hope that explains it a bit better. A lot of these do run like a hit and miss, simply because they're very crude engines. This was the Briggs & Stratton of its day, but quite collectible now. Anyway, I'm going to attempt to show you turning it over, so I'll move it forwards. It's a bit of a mammoth, this thing. It weighs quite a lot. It's got so much compression, I can hardly turn it over, and of course it's compressing every stroke because the exhaust valve's not being operated, but it should allow you to see the atmospheric valve working, or at least hear it. There you are, so I should think you could hear that working there. And of course, if you turn the engine on to compression, just hear the exhaust works there as well. But she's got tons of compression. Yeah, so that is really, really good. Really pleased about that. So yeah, there we are, cylinder head on. Obviously that stud's quite a lot longer than it needs to be, so I might cut it down just to make it more in keeping. Obviously, points to bear in mind with this gasket, I used Hollymore Blue. I tend to use that on fibre gaskets. Just make sure you get a good seal. And also grease the studs before you put the head on. Of course, making sure the surfaces are all clean. So as it stands now, I should be able to fill her up with water and test it. Just check it's not leaking. With the compression it's got, I shouldn't think it is, but you never know. We're not going to do it tonight because it looks like we're going to have a frost. Obviously I can show you the exhaust on it now. A bit tall, but I quite like that. Should make it a little quieter. Very loud engines. Obviously that needs painting. It was painted at some point with non-heat proof paint. So it's all bubbled when I put it on the Wolseley. But I've got some Blackfriars high temperature paint. So I'll get that sorted. Oh yeah, cream separator there. Dan very kindly gave me that gearbox there for that, so I can, should be able to have that on the rally field this year, or next year as it will be. I was going to try and show you, if I get it on compression, I can't really hear it, but no. I was getting some, if I pushed it onto compression, press the exhaust valve, you could get some really loud bangs out of it. Shows you just how loud this engine will be when running. Anyway, that's enough of my ramblings. Obviously, I am very pleased with that. That's great. I've never made a head gasket out of this stuff for an engine of this size. Always bought them, so that's quite nice. Might just get the mixer gasket and put that on.